Good morning to everybody. Normally, our president, Massoum Bourak, should have been with us today. He is the chair of our governing board, and this initiative is framed within what Jean-Paul has mentioned, one of these corporate initiatives that the governing board has wanted to launch and support. Unfortunately, you know, and Jean-Paul has mentioned it, what happened in Turkey. And the situation is not completely settled over there, so he couldn't come. He asked me to address you and to give you his best wishes of success for this meeting. You know that you are here, and Jean-Paul has mentioned it also. In fact, he has said a lot of things I wanted to say, but. You are here in one of the four Mediterranean institutes that are constitutive of SIAM. So welcome to Montpellier. For those of you who have come specially for this meeting, I hope that you'll have the occasion of visiting the city. It is worth, and even the region, it's a beautiful and privileged region. As you know, SIAM has been created 50 years ago to develop the spirit of international cooperation among agricultural professionals in the Mediterranean region, and mainly through providing supplementary education in the aspects of in economic, scientific, and technical aspects, but also to promote joint research and joint development projects. As an intergovernmental organization composed of 13 countries, SIAM promotes multilateral cooperation in the Mediterranean in the fields of agriculture, food, but also fisheries, rural territories development, and we aim at giving a response to the needs that are formulated by our member countries and by the components of the agro-food sector. We are going to speak about doctoral cycles, doctoral studies, and in this we will keep in mind that SIAM is not a university. SIAM is an intergovernmental organization. It has different structure. Its aims are targeted towards giving practical solution and answering our stakeholders, meaning our countries, the institutions that compose, that are part of our associated institutions, and also the agricultural sector. So when we come to education in SIAM, educational activities, the basis and the core of our activity is represented by the master programs. We give more than 20 master programs a year in these five priority areas. And the fact is that by the structure, by the academic structure of these masters, which are 120 credits and 2 years, the students have already completed a whole year of research. And most of them, they have continued to PhD cycles and still wish to continue to PhD cycles. So accompanying them and supporting them has arisen as a challenge for us, because we feel that as our masters are done within a multilateral and multicultural frame, receiving these young researchers in the institutes, we really need to continue and support them and introduce them to the PhD cycle. But remember, we said we are not a university, and by no way we have the means of delivering any PhD diploma. But we are engaged into supporting our students. So how do we do it? Basically, we have developed three types of approach, the main one being very general, meaning we receive the students, we accompany them, and we try to support them as they have done already a year of research. They are already integrated either cooperating universities or research institutions. And we also have contacts and connections with the national cooperation institutions that finance doctoral cycles. So we try to support and accompany them. Naturally, we give access to our research facilities. For those of you who don't know the Institute, I hope that you will have the occasion of visiting the Institute. If you were in other institutes, we have with us the colleagues from two institutes that are also engaged in this activity of supporting PhD cycle. We have Panos with us, he is in charge of this activity in Chania, and we have Marun. I was going to call you by your family name, El Boudjaber. And we have Marun from Bari. And if you had the occasion of visiting the institutes, which I hope you would see, that the positioning of the activity is very different, because the infrastructure, the structure, the scientific accompanying is different from one and from one to the other institute. So one of the ideas of this, of coming together, is that we would like to contrast with you which ways we can foresee to channel this support and how we can rationalize and organize this support to the PhD cycles. For this, we have also been in contact with important regional institutions. We have had the support of the Union for the Mediterranean, and Nuria Jovet has come here to participate to the round table. We had the support of the l'AUF, l'Agence Universitaire de la Francophonie. Madame Sissor is with us. And we also had the support of one of the UMR here in Montpellier. About the topic of this first forum, we have, as we said, we are at the service of our member countries. We have a biannual meeting of ministers of agriculture that discuss about recommendations and priorities in relation to SIAM, and this is the topic of this meeting, meaning sustainable agriculture and food system production. They're constantly, recurrently being identified as one of the main priorities in the area. So we are at the core of a priority for SIAM developing educational and research projects. And not only are we, but it will be more and more and more. In September, the ministers will meet again, and you will see that the message is going again to cross sustainability of agricultural production. The last thing I wanted to say is that, and Jean-Paul has mentioned it already, but I want to stress it, we have, the governing board has been discussing the strategic agenda of the institutions from here to 2025, 2030, and within the corporate actions that we think should frame our activities, the establishment of, I don't know if we can dare to call it at this time a regional doctorate platform, but at least a sustainable institutional, interinstitutional and regional exchange, and a mechanism that will allow us to coordinate the efforts and the scarce resources, because they are scarce for everybody, and this in benefit of you, in benefit of the young doctoral students and the young researchers, giving them the opportunity of interchanging not only on methodologies, on research results, but also having the opportunity of getting a mobility within this doctoral cycle. And you have seen that one of the modalities, and mainly here in Montpellier, is a support within a mobility scheme. And these are short supports. And we have also in the Institute of Bari and in Chania other types of support, more long-term support for realizing the research along the whole cycle of the doctoral. So thank you again for being here. Thank you very much to all the colleagues of SIAM that have been involved in the preparation of this forum. And I really would like to thank Marun and Panos and all the colleagues from Bari and Chania who have been very active in organizing this. And needless to say, Atem and all the colleagues of Montpellier who have borne the big burden of the organization of this first forum. So, as I said, this is the first one. This is, if I would say, SIAM would go public in saying we are doing this in terms of doctoral cycles. Where and how are we going to head with the resources and with the partners we have? So, I think that thoughts have to be given to the modalities for a future clarification, giving more legibility to a regional system, or at least the embryo of a regional system. I think that the people that are governing SIAM, meaning the representatives of the countries, what they will be interested is to know that you have met here, that you have discussed on sustainability of agriculture and food system, what you think is relevant of research thematics and priority, but also how you and then how we in SIAM will interpret the way we can go forward to a more clear regional and sustainable mechanism to support you doctoral students. Thank you again for being in Montpellier today.